Hello everybody, this is Sonia. Sorry about this, I haven't got my camera plugged in. That's not going to help me, is it? Plug in the charger. I won't have to worry about running out of battery, will I? How's that? There we go. Now, today I am looking at doing something a little bit different. Well, it's going to be including embroidery, so that's not too much different, but so now I'm going to make a applique on a check piece of fabric. I just ironed that. Now I've creased it all up. It's okay, but I think what I found, what I wanted to use, is a piece of that on this, I think. Although I have got, so today I've been cutting out pieces off of curtain fabric. Just pieces that I can maybe use. So you need to put a piece with a flower or something. You know, there's not necessarily a flower, but the flower's going to be looking good, I think. Now, so I don't think I haven't settled on one of those yet. Where was the bit I want? Oh, here. I think I want that bit. I don't know. So I've got these other pieces ready. And that's probably just the same as that there, isn't it? Yeah, well, I think I'll just cut it out of here, I think. So we're doing a sort of applique embroidery piece, okay? And this here, I do like too, on the pink. So that would be on the blue, and this one here, this is nice. But to cut that out, I'd need a bit of leaf with it, and it has a real lot, and I'd have to just be really selective about that. So I might just leave that a minute or two, and I'll just... might have to run the iron across this thing here for a second, if it's still a bit hot. Just that bit there so I can cut that out. So I'm going to show you, actually I could pin them on the piece and then I'll show you how to do one of them, I guess. Just depends how much time we have. Hope everybody's having a good day. Australia is nice and warm. Oh, actually, where I am is anyway, which is really weird because it seems like it's gone from spring to summer. That's what it feels like, you know. Feels like that outside. So that'd look really good on there, I think. You know, so this piece here is very heavy. It's a piece of something that you would use as upholstery, for upholstery somethings or other. Okay, bought a new pair of embroidery scissors yesterday, and I'm going to... put something on them, probably tape. I think the string gets caught in everything that I'm doing, and I'll find the tape shortly because I'm not really ready to do that just yet. I'll just use them, but see, I've got that many pairs of scissors now, and they're all been used for glue and stuff like that. So these ones I bought yesterday, bought these at Woolworths actually, and they are really good. They're called CAR, carbon stainless steel, and I've had some for years that I've I kept in the drawer next to the bed in case I want to cut strings off a few clothes, you know, that they put on to keep them on the hangers or something. Some, in case there's some reason I might need them. So, and they've been past glue and everything, so I just want a new pair to do me embroidery with. Now, just cutting the cottons off, not necessarily cutting out the fabric because I've got those two. Okay, so where's a bigger pair of scissors? I'm sure I had some here a minute ago. They're avoiding me now. Okay. Well, I haven't taken yesterday's projects off the table because I'm still going to be doing some work on that. That's for our series on sampler. So I've got that piece. This is to put it onto. Now, this you could use later on to make anything out of. So, you know, there's, you don't have to, if you've got something that's bigger that you want to put onto, like a side of a bag for a pocket or put a piece on the front of a book, or there's just endless ideas. I probably don't show you enough ideas, and I probably should, but it'll all work out. You'll see something eventually that we're going to do with things. I will do something with this. As I said, I can't say again because I'll get into trouble for half saying something about my channel might be changing, and I don't know what to do about it yet, so we'll have to see what happens, eh? So I'm going to cut out this. Hopefully I can still stay on here. I can still stay here. See how it works. See what happens. It's all to do with the government. They need from you and that sort of thing. So I'm going to have to see what happens. So I'm going to cut this out. Fussy, cut it. Okay. Hopefully I haven't got anything too thin that's going to fray away on me. Maybe I should look at doing that piece there that I just did a little bit wider so it wouldn't fray, because this is very, very open, this piece. Very open weave it is. So you pick out something that you want to put on and just fussy cut it out, okay? I'm sure that'll be fine. Because you, through the week I just will put up videos on like other sorts of things and ideas for you. And I think on Tuesday we'll have that series thing, because that was Tuesday that I've put the first one up. So that's fraying back a little bit too much, that is. For my liking. I'm here. I'm sorry, I'm just involved terribly in what I'm doing here. I've just got it might make this a tiny bit wider than what it would be, because I'm going to sew it, so it will. Now if you want to put something behind yours, like stabilizer, can do that, fabric stabilizer of some sort, so it won't fray. At the moment I'm not scared at the moment, but we'll see what happens, eh? I just like the way that these things look on the squares. I just like the way that you have that square background checks, I should say. See what I mean? Look at that. That's just awesome, isn't it? Now I've got to go in here and cut this bit out here. A bit further. So we've got a little issue with our hot water service. And they said they should have it fixed in 20 days. This afternoon, if I haven't heard from the plumber, I'm not going to be happy about this 20-day thingy. There's no way one should be having to go without hot water for that long. That's ridiculous. Their policy is to fix things within that time limit. Now, that looks really cool already. Look at that. Look at the difference that made. Okay. Well, I like it on here, but I think I like it on there better. Now, I'm actually going to put some glue stick behind this because I want to keep it in a reasonably cozy nest. Now, piece of something under glue. I need a glue book, and I don't have a glue book here somewhere, do I? There's nothing like that around here today. Here we go. Piece of this will work, because I just don't want to get it everywhere, and I don't want to unglue that. We're still on the shot, just okay. So we'll put that on there. Now, like I always say to you, or usually do, that this is nobody else's idea. I mean, what can I say when I say nobody else's idea? People have done this, but I don't know how they've gone about it. This is how I'm going about mine, okay? I don't know how anybody else does. I'm not saying that this is what you have to do. There's no rules, I don't think, but it's good. It's interesting to me. I really like that. Now I'm going to just do the other one before I start stitching on one of them. Don't you think that looks awesome? Maybe even two little squares. Two would have been an idea as well. So, and I've got this one. Now this to me looks like the policeman's scarf or something. Colours. There's something on that colour bees off here. I don't see policemen a lot, so I don't really know. But I think it's one of their colours. Some of their colours. I don't know about that either. I'll have to look into that. So now I've got this one to put on here. Now, how big is my piece of material? I'll have to go that way, I think. Well, that one, that's really cool. That's going to take, you know, one or two days to do that. How about I cut out this one here because it's got not much around it. I'll just cut around that one, eh? I think. I'll just cut around this one here. It's got a lot of work on this one. This is like crewel for crewel work. This is the design is called, I think it's a Jacob thing. I think that's how you say it. I'm not quite sure. Something, to be honest with you, I've seen, you know how sometimes you see a word and you never really think to look at it properly? I love you. Unless you have to actually use it in something, and then I should have done this morning, I suppose, because I'm going to have to find the book with it in. Now I can go down there. So I'll need that bit up there, won't I? Because I want, when I say that bit up there, I mean this piece. I need this piece. This is very thick, this one, too, but it's a open, fairly open weave, and what I mean by that is, you know, your stitches are, you know, you count like you do, how you count your stitches on your bed sheets, or how many go that way, how many go that way. So this is really open, within the inch. It's probably 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, about 24 C. So it's very open. Once you put a 1,000 thread count on count in your sheets, they are really, really tightly woven and very good quality once you do that. So, and probably worth buying because I've had my white pair for, since a year dot, and they're still white and they're still good. Ones in the summertime, and then the new ones I bought should be right for two. So, hated the sheets years ago, and because they used to do all that little pilling thing, you know. Oh dear, didn't like that at all. They've managed to work them out now, so that doesn't happen. I hope. I'm hoping. I'm sure it would be right. You get what you pay for, too, I suppose. It's really good though. If you're a VIP customer at Spotlight, you get a fair bit off. So I nearly saved, I saved $70-something because of the pairs of sheets were worth 100 and something in the first place. And each pair went down to, so I got two of them for the price of one, sort of, two pairs. And that's really good. Rightio. Around here now. So I can do a bit of work on this over the next day or two, I suppose. Although I need to do another tag because I've got to do number 14. I think I'm up to, we're up to 14 on the tags. A little fluff about, don't you? A fair bit of fluff about. Oh dear, that looks pretty, doesn't it? And I'm going to take it this way, I think, because I need it to go like that. I do like that. Isn't that nice? I always say that I like to use a plain background, but when I've seen things done like this, I think you should go with this myself. I'm going to tear that there and just cut this up here. And then that's a good piece, and that'll look really nice on something. Excuse me. Now, just for curiosity's sake, I have some yellow here. It's a very small square. Hasn't been pressed today, but on there, oh, it looks good too, doesn't it? Wow. Well, see, I've got plenty more of these pieces, so I could do that. I could put them on, you know, different ones. But I think it has more of an impact on the blue. Don't you reckon? Or not? I don't know. Yeah, I like it. Okay. So today I'm going to try the smaller one just to, you know, get started with. I'll just put some glue stick behind the back of this while I'm at it. What did you do with that piece of paper? So make sure you don't stick that on where the glue is. Oh dear. Well, I've got to got to get my wrist protector things on my arms. Ooh. Right, where did it go back on? I didn't take it off the piece of paper. Put it back in. I was just having a bit of an issue with my hand there. It's all right. As soon as the winter starts coming this way, Sonia's got to... Now, didn't get that right in the middle, but it doesn't matter. Doesn't have to be a little bit offset. Doesn't matter. Okay? So that's what we're going to do today. Now we're going to figure out what stitches we're going to put on. And then we're going to do embroidery on the actual thing itself as well, which it's up to you whether you do it on your piece of work, but I don't think that would be an issue for me. I'm going to put some thread, but I do think I want something the same colour around the edge of it. Okay. This one here, it's a nice hot pink piece. That might look good. We'll go with this piece. Now, this is a piece of crochet cotton. I do know the names of things. It's just sometimes they just don't come straight to you because my brain has got things working on it all the time. It's got things going around in it all the time about next and what's next and what's next, you know. There's that bit for that as well. There'll be some green. Of course, there's going to be green. We do love our green. Different pinks. Some different pinks in there. I should be using the ones that are on the reel, but on the card, but I can use these. Nobody worries about that. I can use these. It's okay. I'm going to have to turn the fan on now. I'm sorry about this, but it will make a noise, but I can't operate without the fan. Can't operate without a fan. Mouthful of water. You've got to have all the things to keep you going, don't you? I said to Jeremy, because he was going out to water, I said, when you come back in, I'll get you to get me a drink. He said, I better get it now in case you start coughing. I said, righto, okay. I'm good. Okie dokie. So this is a piece of, I'd say that's, something's got to have it written in here somewhere. No, none of them do. I can't tell you what size it is, but it's a good size, so sorry about that. Let me see, here we are. Written in this one, yes. It is a 10 gram pearl ball. And the cotton. They are, because they're all the same, what I've got here in front of me. Size 8, okay? It's 8. And I should remember that, but sometimes you just don't, do you? Now, instead of going right around the outside, I'm going to actually go around individual individual petals like this. Righto, so I'm going to start in here and I'm going to work around that one, okay? In blanket stitch, why not? It's the best, it's very versatile, it is very versatile. And it really gives this a different sort of look. It does. Oh, this is going to be fun. Yesterday when I was in here doing that mushroom, I did like doing that so much. It was just so good fun. Still got a little tiny bit to finish on it, but I'm going to put both... I'll put up two episodes next week because... I don't want to, like, till the mushroom's finished, I'll put it up two in the one day for you, because I had to turn it off because it was me lunchtime and that, but I'll come on, I'll put them both up at the same time for you, so that actual sample will be finished. Okay. Now, when I do this round here, I'm going to do the thing where I like to make it so it's sitting up, a bit of three-dimensional, you know, thingy. Now I've got these, they're a good way apart, and I don't know what, you know, what people think. I like the idea that they are, got a little bit of a gap, because it looks good. I just do, I like it, I like the look. So you can put them fair, right up close to one another. If you've got nothing else to do because I think it'd take a little while. People do it with the machine. I can't do that. I don't want to do that. I'm looking for, it's the look I'm going for, and this is it here, see? So, hope I'm not waffling on too much today. I don't know. I've got issues with a few things. A new chair that I bought for out in the lounge room. It's got some issues with it, and I'm waiting for them to come today, and they said they're going to tweak it. I don't know about that. I have to do more than tweak it. It's the most uncomfortable thing I've ever sat on now. But anyway, because I can't get up and down off a lounge chair. But anyway, so they said they're going to come this afternoon and do that. So that's interesting. I suppose we'll see how that goes. I'm always looking for my comfort. I can't help myself, though. And we're looking at buying another mattress for our new bed, and because we didn't replace it as well, and I'm a bit worried about whether I can get myself up onto that because I'm short and I need a sunken down bed a bit. Now, so I'm going to stop here because I figure that piece there will be incorporated in this one going around here, okay? So I'm going to stop here with that. Okay. And I can start... how long have I got? I'll go over here. Might have to do this in a couple of episodes too because I'm sorry, but it takes a little while to do things and I do like to do them properly, so... And a lot of times I only get to show you part way of the work and then it doesn't... I don't get to finish off showing is what I've done. I do want to do more than this in this one, so this could be a little tiny series on how I'm going to make these pieces to put on your bag, book, and that'd look nice on a book cover, wouldn't it? Wow, yes. All right, now we'll go around here. I'll just go around this one here. So that comes down to there, right? So you've got your individual petals. And I'll just keep working on this until you get sick of looking at me, I suppose. I don't say that because people... I don't mean that mean, I'm sorry. I just feel like... I love to watch anybody doing embroidery. A lot of the time, though, it's not in English and it's sort of really off-putting because... It's nice to have somebody, like, helping you with what they're doing, see? It really is. And if they're telling you how they're going, it's really good. So some of them ladies other country, in a lot of different countries to where we are in Australia, and not English-speaking countries, I was trying to say. They do the most amazing work. Now, where am I going, people? Down around here, aren't I? I'll do one more there and come down this way. Because then when I do the other one, it'll... This is going to cut this in half here. All right, so there's two petals there. Hope you can see this. I'm trying to hold it up a little bit higher than... And it's really comfortable for me anyway, so I hope that's all right. I hope you can see what I'm doing. Doesn't this make a difference to what it looked like before? Okay, should I go one more down? I might do a small one. Just to do a small one in there. Because I want to use, like I said, I want to use that darker colour in the middle. Oh, this piece here is darker there too. And one more bit across the top here. Well, we still got the cotton on. So I hope you can find yourself a piece of fabric that's got nice big flowers on. I went yesterday to the Salvation Army and the lady had these ones that she gave me, but see, because there's lots of off, oh, she didn't give me, I bought, paid a couple of dollars, 50 cents. See, look what I've got there. I'll cut that out and put it on something. That'll look good, won't it? I won't have time to sleep. It's all right. I didn't have any sleep this afternoon because I've decided I'm going to try not to. Actually, I dozed for about 15 minutes and that did me. So I got a good sleep last night. Okay, around here. Let me see. Does that come down here? And then that one can go around there. There's another piece of this material. I suppose I'm not going to be able to actually see what's going on because I've... You can't because it's all... But you can make that then... You can get that designed to be your own thing, can't you? Be your own design. I am really pleased all you ladies are going to help go with the sampler thing. It's going to be fun, isn't it? Even this one can be one you can put on. You can start another sampler. I think it's going to be large. We might be able to make a bedspread because all the time I keep coming up with different ideas. This piece could be one too if you wanted it to be. But I'll have to do something else in between doing that. I wish I could work out which way that flower's going. I really do. I can't seem to figure that out. They're only small, the petals, aren't they? So I'm thinking I'm going to come down through here. I am. This is where I'm going with it. Okay. Now you can get you can get things off the cotton fabric too. You don't have to use this heavy stuff. Let me show you. Like that rabbit piece I got. Got little flowers and that on it. And that might do for there. And we'll end that off. See, this has got a bit of mauve in that too, so I'd like to keep that on there. Just take it through the back and put a little knot on there to hold on to it. When you pull it, hold on to your piece of fabric with your finger and your thumb so you don't pull it through and wrinkle all your work. Let me see, where's a bunny one here that I'm sending to? Doyen? Is it Doyen? Sorry people, I have so... There's lots of you just look after me and be on my channel. I keep forgetting who's who and what your name's. Doyen? See that there? You could cut that out and do that, couldn't you? You could do your bunny too, and that's what... And the bird. You know, bouquet them as well, so you can find little bits on the cotton fabric. And like this one I showed you before. That sort of thing. Very busy though, but you could just take that bit out and then you could go and find a leaf. Anyway, there's more of that in the ideas. Okay. Oh dear, there's the water. I'll have some more of that. Now, the leaves can be done with the same stitch because this piece I'm doing with the same stitches. The other piece that I want to do is going to be done with those cruel embroidery stitches. That one there. That's got a lot of stitches on it, okay? This French knot's going to go around in there. I'll have a detached daisy chain on that. There's just so many and lots of different colours, so that's what we're going to put on that one when I get to there. So this one here, we'll come back onto here and we're going to put... I'm going to put the... There's no, that's nowhere near the... Excuse me, the right colour. It is what goes in here though, isn't it? I'm a bit of trouble here, this thing isn't caught. We'll go in there, it won't go in there, see if I can find a colour for that. I did bring in another box of cotton that I had out in the lounge room. There's that one there. It's really dark, but it's good. Oh, here we go. There's a piece with, this is a bit of embroidery thread. When I say that, I should have said crochet cotton. Any crochet cottons. Nice, hey? Rightio. I'm going to put this one on in the middle. I've got to think about this a second. I don't know, because I'm not sure what sort of stitches to do on it, whether I should just keep going with this or not. So I haven't found my little person either, that people that I want to make for this. Things. I'll have to have a look in the magazines or something, see if I can find a person I can copy for the stitch, for our stitch story. That bunny thing back over here, because it's going to get wet on that if I'm not careful. Wet when I say, because it's sitting on the... me wet wipes that I always seem to have open. Excuse me. There we go. That'll fix it. Close it, Sonny, that's the way. So I'm going to do a little, I think maybe a long, wait a minute, a good idea if I have a bit of cotton on that, knot on the cotton. Okay, too many things in my brain. Now I'm going the wrong way, I need to go over there. I can go backwards, but you better not do that to you. This is very exciting for me. I really am really enjoying this because, as you know, I do love to do embroidery, but I hadn't been doing it because I got stuck into the junk journaling for a while there. I was hooked on that. Now I'm going to do these ones in a long blanket stitch. Like if I sit here and I work it out, I'm going to do them straight down here and across there. Okay, so I'm going to start over here and cover the whole of the burgundy piece. Cover it all, righto? Because it's only small and you can do that, right? You can cover the whole thing up. Oh, we're watching this Stephen King story and geez, it's, oh, I can't even begin to say what I think. It's scary, it's weird, it's really creepy, it's, I can't tell this one, I can't, no. Oh dear, it's something that we're going to actually keep looking away from. But the storyline, sort of, is really good. You know how there's something that you've got to keep looking at it because you've got to see what's going to happen. I hate it when you don't know what's going to be the end result, and so we're going to have to just watch it. There's two seasons, 20 episodes. But we're just sort of hooked on, well, maybe not Jeremy so much, but I am. I like to find out what's going on. I want to know what's going to happen. So now I'm going to make a little space there. I'm going to turn that thing off. When that gets around to 10 past, I can turn that. So I'm going to make a space because I know there's nothing, like there's no flower bit there, so that's okay. I'll see what it looks like, and if it needs joining up later, I can do that. So I'm just making these stitches the whole size of, I'm just covering over my, because you don't really want to cover the whole flower, but you do want to do, you know, a good job. You don't want to cover it all because you want to be able to see that that's what you eventuated from that, if you understand. So, yes. I'm going to have to go. I'll be back in a minute, okay? Bye-bye.